Hey guys, Michael Garber here from my luxurious and spacious office here in Hollywood, California. I'm here today because of a conversation that Chris Fenwick and a guy whose alias is Droid on Twitter had last week on that post-chat, weekly chat that the kids do with the Twitters and their cell phones and the typing and the whatnot, where Chris explained my broadcast commercial workflow that I demoed for him on the first morning. He was my first demo at NAB in the FCP Works suite at the Wynn Hotel. And Droid was curious to know what it is that I'm doing with that. So just so you know, this is something I figured out about a year ago, and I've kind of been honing and crafting it since then and giving private demos to people. And I finally got some time together so that I could record this. It's about a 10 or 15 minute demo, so sit back and relax and enjoy the show. So what this is a commercial workflow whereby you have separate source audio that was shot jam synced. And what jam synced means that your audio recorder and your camera are synced up to record the same time code at the same time. And utilizing some really interesting workflow in Final Cut Pro, you can actually merge the logging information that your sound recordist adds on set to your picture. So let's get moving here. The other exciting part about all of this is that you can prep your footage in a really short amount of time. So what we have here is our dailies. We've got our A cam and our B cam and our audio here. And I'm going to open this up here, and these are the files that were created by the Sound Devices Recorder. And there's a program called Wave Agent out there, and I'll open that up. And if I just drag a clip in here, what we see is all of the info that a WAV file can store. So we've got our character names based on which channel mic that they're on. So Will is on 1, Mike is on 2, Mary is on 4, we've got Boom on 5, Mix left and Mix right on 7 and 8. And we've also got the scene and take info, as well as the project. Snossages. Hey, look at that. We got the big Snossages campaign.
Snossages.
What to do?
Snossages. Snossages.
Can't wait to cut this job. Now, what we're going to do here is simply drag and drop this into Final Cut. We'll bring the footage in first, and I'm just going to bring in a whole bunch of dailies. My first step in this process is that we're going to label the camera angles on the video clips. So we can see that here, all the A clips start with A0. And I've got to blur out this all the video here, but you're not going to miss much. And the B cam here is reflected in B0, and then we've got all our audio clips down here. So what I'll do quickly is just type in A0. We're over here in our info pane. We want to be in general or extended. And I'll change the angle to cam_A. Oops, I'm going to do that the correct way this time by selecting all of the clips that are cam A. There we go. And I'll do the same for camera B. And now, in some other methods, we would actually label the audio Z_audio. And our purpose for that would be when we make our multicams that it would add the audio to the third angle, since the Z alphabetically comes after A and B. But in this scenario, we actually don't need to do that because the audio is going to get synced with the video. One quick thing we can see is that the scene and take info matches the shots and matches what's in Wave Agent here, 3073. We've got 307. We see that's 307, 1, 2, 3, right there. Okay, so how do we get all this together? Well, there's a really cool program called Sync and Link. And all we need to do is, let's call this Snossages Day 1. 01? Why not? I'm going to go ahead and export this XML to the desktop. Open up this program called Sync and Link. And what Sync and Link does is it syncs together our second source audio that has been recorded with the same time code as the picture. And I'll drag that over, hit open. And in a very short amount of time, we're going to see that it's currently analyzing all the clips. There we go. So there's a couple different functions here, and what I'm going to do is leave the video clips name the same, but you can actually merge the video and audio, or just the audio. Those names of the audio clips could become the new clips. And all that metadata, which in this case is the scene and take info and circle take info, we can add that to the clips. And we can even adjust our audio if we know beforehand what the offset is. We can also redo it after the fact if we had to, if we figured out once we synced it and got it back into 10 that there was an issue. And this is the most important part for me. These track names from the audio IXML become subroll names. The audio IXML, just so you know, as far as I understand, is this track info here. I don't know if it pertains to this info or not, but I do know that it pertains to this. And these become subrolls, which become very important. I'm a big fan of subrolls and rolls. These are going to flow through to our audio mix. And then what it does is a little round robin here. It takes those subroll names and it copies them and turns them into the audio component names. And we'll see how that works in a second. So I'm just going to sync the clips. It'll ask you where you want to save the XML to. We'll just go ahead and save that to the desktop for now. Let's go ahead and open that up in new library. And it's created a new event here. And mind you, I have import leaf files in place turned on because what might happen is if that was turned to copy files in the library, it would then copy all these clips a second time into the library, which we don't want. Okay, so this is our synced, new synced event. And sync and link creates a keyword collection which contains all your synced clips. So now what we'll see here is that this audio is synced to the picture. And if I click on the audio tab here and I pull that down, we see that that's our camera audio. And I can turn that off. And if I pull down this tab here, we see that all those names show up here. So now we're not editing worrying about track numbers. We're editing worrying about character names. That changes things, actually, when you start to think about it. It makes editing go a lot quicker because you can just look at a person on screen. You know who they are because you're working with that character. And you can just quickly turn off all these and turn on just the character. And you don't have to worry about the jigsaw puzzling of different tracks and where we're going to put things because these will be connected to the picture. Okay, so I could go on in this a lot longer, but I will try to move forward quickly. So these are all the synced clips, A and B cam. I'm going to select all of these and I'll go into info and we're going to apply a custom name very simply. We'll name this by the scene shot taken angle. So because all that metadata was there beforehand, we know that it's 301 take one cam A. And we can find that very quickly down here. Let's see. Cam A and Cam B. Here we go. Starting on 307, we've got Cam A and Cam B together. And so in this scenario, what I'd like to do is actually take the entire morning's worth of dailies and turn them into a multi-clip. And that's really easy, quick, and painless. I'll show you all that I have to do here. I'm just going to select these and I can right-click on them. I have a key command set up for multicam clips, but just to show you, we're going to make a new multicam clip here. And we're going to call this
Sausages.
Morning shoot. And the key here is don't do any custom settings. Do not let the audio synchronize because the time code is already jam synced. We'll hit OK, and it's that quick. Now, if I double click this, should have worked. There we go. We have the entire morning's worth of dailies. Now, I have some reasons for doing this as one long multi-clip as opposed to turning these all into separate multi-clips. I would prefer to work this way. There's a little issue with Final Cut in terms of dealing with batch audio changes on separate multi-clips, even if they have the same audio configurations. So, without going into too much detail, this is how I chose to do it on this job. I'd prefer to do it a little differently, but this works well. So there's a little trick here that I want to show you all. If I pull down the audio now, we see that we've got, 9 channels of audio, and all the names are gone. Well, that doesn't really help us. So there's a little trick here. If I pull this down and I hit reset, it brings them all back. There's a little dialog box that usually will come up there asking if you want to do it. And I've checked the box that says don't bring that up. But we've now got all the track names the same. Now, there's a real trick here that you all need to know. If you're going to use this method, all the clips here on the cam A angle need to have the same audio configuration. All these clips here need to have the same audio configuration for this to work properly. If this clip here was shot with, say, a different sound recorder or four channels or just a different configuration or different names, then we would want to create a new angle for that clip. But if I select all these clips, we know, and I draw these down, we can see these are all the same. So that's a good thing. Okay. So what's the exciting part about all this? Well, if I was to create an edit, and we'll call this Snossages Commercial A, and I start editing some clips into the timeline, first things first, when I look at this clip here, again, we can see who's talking. So I can turn all these off and just turn on the characters that I want. And now when we expand the audio here, we just see it shown as a mixdown or stereo, but we can expand the components here and see these two channels active or components. Now what's important is that a lot of people, when they start cutting in 10, what they'll do is that they'll expand components with everything active, and then like in Final Cut 7 or other NLEs, they'll just turn off the channels that they don't want here by hitting the V key, selecting and hitting the V key. I just want to say that I really highly recommend against doing that. It could cause issues in terms of timeline performance. So what you really want to do is every time you want to turn off audio and clips is to go into the channel configuration and then turn on just the clips that you want. And now you understand why I made a multi-clip with all the clips inside of it, because what I can do is I can add additional clips. And so let's say I make a cut here. So now this is two clips. If I select these, I can make batch changes to both of them. If these were separate multi-clips, I couldn't do that. And it is only because of the same audio configuration that this is important to me. Now, one thing I also want to show is that I'm going to open up the timeline index, and let's go over to roles. What we see are the active subroles in the timeline. So if I expand the audio components here on this first clip, we see that Will here, this subrole under dialogue, which is a primary role, is highlighted here when I show it. And this entire clip here is selected because the Will subrole is contained within it. If I were to activate all of these, we'd see that they all show up now in the timeline. And this is because of Sync and Link copying the track names over to the role names. This actually can work in an event. If I want to create a new smart collection, I can find one based on roles. And if I turn off, uncheck all of this, and I want to find just the shots that Mary's in, I can quickly find that there. So it's a neat little trick. But the more exciting part is the end of the process, which takes us to logic. And I'm going to skip forward here. We're not going to edit a whole timeline here, but I'm going to take you to the actual commercials AAF that I sent out to the sound mixer. So I would export another XML to the desktop, and I would use a program called X2 Pro. and we would just drag that in there. And when you open up the roles, you can see what roles are active. Now, there's actually a little bug there with the program where it does not automatically filter down with only the audio components that are active in the timeline. It will give you everything. If you're using regular clips, non-synced clips, then it will work in that way. So if you had four of these channels turned off in the timeline, it would know not to turn them on, et cetera, et cetera. But the exciting part here is we can then create the XML here, which we'll go ahead and I think put it on the desktop into this AAF. Now, what I did here is I actually want to show you all the actual timeline that I sent into X2 Pro from the real commercial and show you how it all pops over in there. Okay, so this was the original timeline out of Final Cut Pro. We'll just open this up in Logic. And what we see here that it's done is it's taken all those active clips that have those subrole names on them. So Dialogue Mary, Dialogue Mike, Dialogue Will, Boom, Mix Left, Mix Right, VO, Music. Whereas we don't have tracks in Final Cut 10, what it's done is every time there's a J or an L cut, it's created a second track. And it's put all that same mic, or that character who is on that mic, on the same track. So now the audio mixer doesn't have to do a little track shuffling when they get the AAF. Everything is ready to go. Hopefully, this would save maybe a half a day's worth of work or more, depending on the complexity of the timeline. So this is something I've been really excited to show people. I hope that I've explained myself well and that this all makes sense. This is a pretty high-end workflow. This is not, for shooting your kids' high school play, although it could be in the future if we can figure out a way to jam sync different cameras up and label the sub-roles based on microphones. So anyway, hope that this was something that taught you guys a couple of quick tips. Sorry for the length of this, but it is kind of a complicated thing to explain, but something that saves hours or days from prepping and logging for your edit. Thanks for watching.